Bickley and Marotta mornings.
Arizona Sports, the local sports leader. Bickley Blast.
We are almost to March, where basketball is anything but. March becomes a sprint in the NBA, a time where games get a new level of intensity, where tempers flare and a team's collective identity better be firmly in place. Unfortunately, we are not there yet with the Phoenix Suns. But I will say this. Twice this year, the Suns have lost games that really pierced their contender status, that really shook us to our core. Once it happened to the Clippers, once it happened to the Rockets, and both times they rebounded with sturdy, resounding wins, and both times it came against the Lakers. And we're starting to see some commonality. Balance. When the Suns have it, they look really good. Intensity and urgency. When the Suns really feel it, especially on defense, they look really good. And when they limit their turnovers, when they play with pace, when they hold their own on the glass, they're capable of being a really good team. Problem is, there's a lot of ifs still in the equation, and that has to end. Either way, we all know that beating LA never gets old and is always timely. The last time this team beat the Lakers, it led to a 7-game winning streak, and this time, let's hope it marks the beginning of an ending the Valley can all rally around. All right, today's Bickley Blast brought to you by my great friends at Chapman BMW, who make luxury attainable. Find them online at chapmanbmw.com.
Talk about the big three with Devin, Kevin, but is there like a middle three developing now with Yusef, Grayson, and Royce? They just seemed awfully big for you all.
No doubt. And Eric Gordon. You know, we didn't have Eric tonight, but he's been a big part of it. But those three guys were the stars of the game tonight. You know, I mean, Book and KD did what they had to do. They both hit closer-type shots in the fourth quarter, you know, to help us secure the victory. But, you know, Grayson and Royce with 6 threes each, and Nurk with 22-7. What is it, 22-7 and 18 points? Hell of a night. And guarding Anthony Davis all night. Man, that's just a big-time performance by Nurk.
Big three. Now we got the middle three forming, or the middle four, as Frank
ridiculous.
Vogel wanted to say. But
right,
the
right.
Balance, you're right on the money. The balance is what stood out yesterday.
Yes.
And you can't – I don't think this team can count on that every single night. But in a game, you know, the game unfolds in a certain way and balance is presented to you. Hey, role players, you can step up and really get your fingerprints on a win, and they do it.
Mm-hmm.
That's only good moving forward.
And as you pointed out earlier, Royce O'Neal, he's been really, really good since coming to the Suns. He is not afraid to take shots, and
no.
He makes them more often than Josh Okogie does, which is good. So, because this is really going to be the secret sauce to this team. We've seen this now for years, especially when you've got guys like Devin Booker and Kevin Durant. This team has had the tendency in the fourth quarter of high leverage games to get tight. And they get tight because they play ISO ball. And then they work the clock, and then the clock gets into a deficit situation, and then everything kind of falls apart. It is much better if this team can get to a level where it doesn't come down to that. Now, there are going to be moments in the postseason where you give the ball to KD or Book and you say, everybody clear out, get out of the way. Mm-hmm. That's just the way you do it. But you do need to have guys who are going to make big shots.
And they definitely did that yesterday.
They did that yesterday.
Kevin Durant talked about that.
They try to live with something against us and giving up open threes and layups and paint attempts because they want to stop us so bad. When Brad's not out there, guys came through and knocked down shots. And I think we got it like the Dallas game, Houston game. We didn't do a good job of exploiting that and getting other guys shots, specifically myself. You got to be better at that moving forward, especially with Brad not being there. And, you know, I think that's only going to be good for our team. Guys got to step up and do more and, you know, have a different role some nights. That's only going to make us better.
Yeah, the Bradley Beal question looms because he's now missed 3 games post All-Star break after mm-hmm. tweaking that hamstring before the break. And I know the feeling going into the break was, wow, it didn't look that major. You know, it's coming at a great time. If it's an injury for Bradley Beal, you got a week to get things settled. And now we're going on 2 weeks with this hamstring injury. Frank Vogel told us last week that he was confident that he'd be available for the Dallas game. Still not ready to go.
Yeah, and you see these videos of his pregame workouts, and it looks like he's
pretty
letting
vigorous.
Yes, and so you're like, whoa. So is it, what is the deal with this? Well, the deal with this is we're getting the Bradley Beal that he gave the Wizards the last 3 years, a guy that's going to give you about 45 games, and that's unfortunate. It seems to be a reality. Let's just hope that he can put together that stretch of 16 to 25 games when it matters in the playoffs. So I think that I also think that the Lakers are not a team that plays with pace. The Lakers have a size advantage that generally would make things difficult for the Suns. That certainly wasn't the case yesterday. I really like the attitude that Jusuf Nurkić played with yesterday, mm-hmm. right? And they seem to kind of feed off of that. And then you talk about just the big shots that were made at key moments in the game. That was one of the big takeaways for this team. And sometimes it's as easy as that. It's a make or miss league, right, Vinny? Is that what they say?
Yeah, it's a game of runs as well.
Yeah. Yeah, well, that too. But it's like, and I draw the example of the last time they beat the Lakers in what felt like a must-win game. I went back and checked the schedule. What the two games prior to that, they lost a real bad game to Memphis when the Grizzlies didn't really have anybody. Mm-hmm. And then they got just rolled by the Clippers in a game which they didn't even look like they were on the same level as the Clippers. And I remember the next morning going, this team's got some trouble, yeah. is in trouble. And then they went into L.A. and they rolled the Lakers and they put together a nice streak of basketball. Here we are. It's a good time for a nice streak of basketball.
Yeah, the Lakers, too, and they're trying to find their footing, and they're in a play-in spot right now. I don't know if I see them getting out.
I mean,
just based a lot on what we saw from yesterday. I mean, LeBron's LeBron.
Mm-hmm.
Anthony Davis put in two different performances yesterday. Mm-hmm. He was absent in the first half and got dominated by Jusuf Nurkić and was really good in the second half when he decided he wanted to play. D'Angelo Russell was amazing in the first half, did nothing in the second half.
Mm-hmm.
It's like their interest level or their engagement in the game on an individual basis just waned so much.
I look at the team, I don't see a whole lot, and you've been saying this for a while, they just do not look that impressive to me. And going into the game, oh, Rui Hachimura in the starting lineup's made all the... Really? I mean...
He had a nice, okay
he's
game,
a, but, and he's a nice spot up shooter, a big yeah. tall dude. But I don't look at the Lakers and feel fear. I really don't.
I don't either. It's a beautiful feeling to have.
It's a much different feeling when you look at the Lakers. Now, doing that to the Lakers fan base yesterday, that's very enjoyable as well because they're back now at Footprint Center. That was pretty obvious yesterday.
Yeah, and I thought it was going to be different yesterday,
yeah.
but it. It was certainly not different.
No.
And I remember, I feel that way every time the Lakers are in town. Especially feel that way when the Lakers are not good at all.
Mm-hmm.
And they still pack the place. How do they get these tickets?
That's right. I don't know.
And I said earlier in the show, and I truly believe this is going to happen. That is, LeBron's career winds down. The next superstar that'll wear the purple and gold
Giannis.
Of the Lakers, or the
mm-hmm.
forum blue and gold of the mm-hmm. Lakers, is Giannis.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's just this never-ending cycle of unbelievable fortune for that franchise.
It's disgusting, is what it is.
Yeah.
It really, really is. I mean, it's so bad. The NBA commissioner had to negate a trade of Chris Paul to the Lakers at one point in time. You go back; it's unbelievable how lopsided. Some of these deals have been in Lakers history.
They still went and won two championships.
Thanks for watching Bickley and Murata. Click to see the latest Bickley Blast and hit the button in the middle to subscribe to Arizona Sports.